Good morning, everyone. As my student asked about the uniform circular motion, let me explain. The topic about uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion. Before entering into topic, let us see what is circular motion, how it happens. Let us take a small block which has mass m and which is moving in a straight line with v velocity, right? It has uniform velocity. That means its direction as well magnitude also is a constant. We know that velocity is a vector quantity. Vector quantity in the sense it has both direction and magnitude, right? So its velocity and magnitude both, its direction and magnitude both are constant. Now it is moving with v velocity in a straight line. What I have done is, I have applied F force which is perpendicular to the velocity. So, could you guess what will happen now? So, you may think that the velocity may change. I mean, magnitude of the velocity. Let us see now. We know that work done, W is equals to Fs cos theta. Sorry. Now, theta is nothing but angle between the force and displacement. So, as I'm applying perpendicular force, the force perpendicularly, then what will happen? Theta will be 90 degrees. Then, work done W is equals to Fs cos 90 degrees. W is equals to 0. Because cos 90 is 0. The work done by the applied force in this condition is 0. Just imagine now, there is a football. It is moving with uniform velocity in a straight line. Then you have come and you kicked the ball in this direction. When you have kicked the ball in this direction, then what will happen? Definitely it will change its direction. Am I right? Yes, same thing. The applied force is useful to change its direction. But as the force is perpendicular, it is unable to change the magnitude of the velocity. So here the work done zero, as the work done is zero, it cannot create any change in magnitude of the velocity. But what it can do is it can change the direction of velocity, right? Now due to this perpendicular force, the block has reached here. Again, what I have done is the block has it traveled like this. It has taken curved path like this, right? After coming here, now it's this is the velocity direction. Now again, what I will do is I will apply force again, which is perpendicular to the this velocity, right? So as we know, it's a perpendicular force, so the work done is zero. It cannot change the magnitude of velocity, but what it can do is it can change the velocity direction. It can change the velocity direction. As the direction is changing, the block is getting circular path, right? Here, what I am doing is, I am applying discrete forces in the sense, after certain interval of time, again I apply force here, right? I am giving gaps and I am applying the forces. So, due to these kind of discrete forces, the block is getting circular path. Just imagine that, if I apply continuous force, that means if I apply a continuous perpendicular force on the block, then what would be the path of the block? Yes, absolutely, it will get circular path. That means when an object is moving with v velocity in a linear direction with uniform velocity, if you apply on the block force F, which is perpendicular to its velocity, then what will happen? This force will help to change its direction. If you apply continuously, point to point, on every point if you apply, at everywhere if you apply continuously, this perpendicular force, then what will happen? This block or this object will get circular path. It will get circular path, right? So, for example, if you take at this point, the force will be like this, because here this is the direction of velocity. If you take, right, this is the applied force. At this point, this is the velocity, and this is the, sorry, it should be towards the center, right? So this is the force direction. This is the force direction, and it is velocity. At each and every point, by applying force towards the center, what we are doing? We are changing the direction of the object. Due to this perpendicular force, the object is getting circular path, right? Here, at any point, if you consider velocity, the velocity is tangential. The velocity is tangential. Here, due to this force, the block is, or the object is getting motion in a circular path. So this force is called centripetal force. This force is called centripetal force. So we learn about this later, right? So now this is the reason. This force is the reason why should an object is getting a circular path. In the previously, Galileo has told that rest, motion, and uniform circular motion, these three are the natural states of the object. For example, if you leave an object there, it will be there only. For example, if you leave an object there, it will be there only. It don't move. Or else, if an object is moving with uniform acceleration, uniform velocity, it will continue the uniform velocity until apply some force. As like, he thought that even uniform circular motion also is a natural state of the object. But after that, Newton has come and he has told that no, only rest and uniform motion, these two only natural states of the object. Remaining all, if you want uniform circular motion, definitely there must be force, which is called centripetal force. So due to this centripetal force, object is moving. For example, you take our earth. Earth is rotating, So which force acting between the earth and the sun? You know already, gravitational force, right? So this is the very main reason why the object is getting circular motion. Now here, uniform circular motion. Coming to uniform circular motion. Circular motion, if the object is having uniform speed, the velocity of the object is uniform. So is it possible having velocity uniform? No, it's not. Because at each and every point, the direction of the velocity is changing. If you take at this point, this is the direction of velocity. If you take this point, this is the direction of velocity. So we know that velocity is a vector quantity. That means it has direction as well as magnitude. It has direction as well as magnitude. If you here uniform circular motion sense, the magnitude of the velocity is constant. For example, at this point, the velocity is v1. At this point, velocity is v2. At this point, velocity is v3. At this point, velocity is v4. At this point, velocity is v5. Right? So uniform acceleration sense, the magnitude of v1 is equals to magnitude of v2, that is equals to magnitude of v3, and so on. That means throughout the circle, the magnitude of velocity is constant, but the thing is, the direction is present. It changes. If for each and every point, the velocity direction changes. Due to the change in direction, it's not a constant velocity or uniform velocity, because its direction is changing. So velocity is changing. When there is a change in velocity, definitely acceleration will be present. That acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration. Now, what is centripetal force? Centripetal force, F is equals to M into centripetal acceleration. F is equals to M into centripetal acceleration. We'll derive very soon for that formula, right? Now, let us see basic terms. If you coming to linear motion, like straight line motion or whatever it may be, the basic terms are distance, displacement, and velocity, right? Displacement, velocity, acceleration, right? These three are the main thing, right? In uniform motion, right? In uniform circular motion, there will be a few basic terms we'll discuss now. So if it is linear motion, definitely we'll know that displacement, velocity, acceleration. The rate of change of displacement is nothing but velocity. The rate of change of velocity is nothing but acceleration, right? In the same manner, here, for example, this is the starting position of the particle, right? After certain time t, the particle has reached to here. Now, this angle traversed by the particle, this angle covered by the particle or traversed by the particle is nothing but angular displacement. What is that? Angular displacement. What is angular displacement? The angle at center which is covered or traversed by the particle when it is moving in a circular path is called angular displacement, and we denote with theta, right? Next, the rate of change of angular displacement is called angular velocity. What is angular velocity? The rate of change of, if you want to tell very simple, d theta by dt, that is equals to angular velocity omega. Then if the velocity also changes, then angular acceleration. What is acceleration? The rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time. It is denoted with alpha. Angular displacement theta, angular velocity omega, and angular acceleration alpha. Right? Now, what are its units? The angular velocity, angular displacement theta, its units are radians. What about its units? Angular velocity is equal to the change in angular displacement by change in time. That means a radian by second. Right? Coming to alpha, the change in delta. See, what is why did you write here d theta by dt? Again, why did you write delta theta by delta t? Here, if the change is very small, d theta by dt. If the change is very big, then we have to use this. Okay, now? Change is very big, then we use the delta. So, radian per second. Coming to here, the rate of the change in angular velocity with respect to time. That means angular velocity units are radian per second by second. That is equals to radian by second square. These are the units of these angular quantities. Now, when the object is moving in straight line, what about its, of course, an object